From a young age, I had this dream of being Gordie Howe and playing in the NHL. And along came this kid, Gilbert Perreault, and he would pick up the puck, and nobody could get the puck from him. And I remember thinking, wow, this guy's special. And if I couldn't get number 9, I wanted to be number 11.
In 1970, Gilbert Perreault helped make hockey history for the Buffalo Sabres.
Well, he started the franchise as number 1 pick in 1970.
With a spin of a wheel, the NHL's newest team won the number 1 pick and selected Perreault. Famous for his end-to-end rushes, Perreault's dazzling offensive ability was on full display in his rookie season, leaving the fans of Buffalo astonished.
Gilbert Perreault works in.
He probably has more highlight reel goals than any other forward I've ever seen. You could give him the puck behind the net, he could go through the whole team.
I've seen a lot of good hockey players in my life, but I've never seen a puck handler like Gilbert Perreault.
I don't know if there was anyone with better lateral movement, the zigzag, the stop and go, the hands moving as quick as the feet, or vice versa.
When you watch Gilbert skating, he looked like a cowboy. He was bow-legged. It was hard to tell what kind of a move he might be thinking about.
He came down with his legs, you know, 8 feet apart. He could go either way. And you get to the blue line and you say, he's not even skating. He's got his legs planted. But he's flying.
He made so many defensemen look sick.
We were in Boston and he digged Bobby Orr so bad, Bobby fell on his knees. And I said to Gilbert, how'd you do that? He goes, I don't know. I just do it. That's how much talent he had.
After capturing the Calder Trophy as Rookie of the Year, Perreault connected with two fellow French-Canadians to form the most exciting trio in hockey.
René Robert and Rick Martin and Gilbert Perreault, together we're called the French Connection.
Gilbert was the playmaker, and Rico was the goal scorer, and René could do a little bit of both.
Rick Martin, back in.
People were on the edge of their seats. It was a riot. You didn't know what was going to happen next, but you knew it was going to be good for Buffalo.
Throw holes at the circle. Crosses to Robert. Here he comes. Waiting for the score! The French Connection worked their magic again.
When they turned it on, they could just dominate.
We just never had to look. We knew exactly where everybody was. We'd just throw the puck in the hole, and there'd be someone there to get it.
The French Connection indeed was a connection. They were such an electric part of the game.
Powered by Perreault's masterful playmaking, the French Connection catapulted the Sabres to a playoff berth in just their third season and a cup final appearance in their fifth. The dynamic center played in 6 All-Star games, finished top 5 in points 3 times, and ended his career with 512 goals and 1,326 points, though much of his success flew under the radar.
To move him to Buffalo in that first draft, you know, that was a tough spot to put a young guy in.
I don't think Gilbert got the credit that he deserved.
If he played in a major market, he would have gotten more notoriety. But the fact that he was the leader in Buffalo, I think, served him well.
Everybody that knows hockey knew how special he was.
He's in the same category as the Bobby Orr, the Gretzky's, and the Mario Lemieux.
Here we are over 45 years later, and he's still the greatest player that ever played for the Buffalo Sabres. That says everything about him.